Well, I've known Peter for quite a long, too long, some might say. But we went to university, and after we'd finished university, it was about 1985, we decided that it'd be nice to, because we'd always been groups before, you know, at school and everything. It was like a hobby, and we decided to do it seriously. So we just put adverts up in the university for musicians, and went through about 10 drummers, but stuck with the same bassist pretty much, didn't we? Mm. And then we released a single in 1985, and we've released about 5 or 6 singles on our own label, which is called Reception Records, and our first LP, and then a compilation LP of the singles, and then we signed to RCA and released a debut LP with a major LP.
And then came on tour to North America.
And then played in Toronto, and then came out here and did this interview with you. Lost your look of life. Too much apple pie. Have you lost your look of life? Too much apple pie. And that pie is what's away. The time is right. You've got to pick some people up. You've got to let some people go. But if the least thing just come up, I really want to know, because everybody loves a TV show.
The song Kennedy seems to sum up a few of your ideas about the States. Is it sort of ringing true now that you're here, now that you've played, say, the US?
No, not particularly, no.
Not feeling apple pie, have
I? I've done today, actually.
Did you?
I've done the Wendy place.
How are you feeling?
Not bad. No, it's just, I don't really know anything about America or Canada, really. And it was just vague references. Actually, it was because I was writing it about the 25th anniversary of the assassination of the president, and there's millions of television programmes on in Britain. It's probably were here as well, but I presume. And I found them quite interesting, I guess. Lost your look of life. Too much apple pie. Oh, have you lost your look of life? Too much apple pie. And now Harry's walked away with Johnny's wife. You've got to pick some people up. You've got to let some people go. But if Lee's name just come up, oh well, I really want to know. Because everybody loves a TV show. Lost your look of life. Too much apple pie. Oh, have you lost your look of life? Too much apple pie. And now Paris walks away with Johnny's wife. I think I used to make the mistake of writing about things which are a bit too close to me, you know, sort of chronologically. I mean, now I tend to write about things maybe a couple of years old, is it? I remember My Favourite Dress was quite a personal song, and it was like written at the time it was happening, and then I was singing it on stage, and it's really embarrassing because I thought, oh my god, what am I doing? I was like, just like telling everybody these sort of personal secrets on stage, but, so I don't really do that anymore now.
Yeah, I mean, judging from a couple of the tunes that you sort of had a kind of a rough love life, at least. It's
terrible,
point.
Terrible. Mm. I don't know if I've survived, to be honest. I don't know how I've made it here today.
It's all unjustified, isn't it? It's just bad fortune with the people you choose.
Yeah.
It's really awful.
People also say this, but I've said that. If you look at a lot of them, I mean, a lot of songs are about falling in love and the sort of celebration of love. I think it tends to be the better ones which are about breaking up.
Just a point, probably pressed on the road.
That's one reason why we chose to work with Steve Albini, was that Surfer Rose LP, which is really one of our, it's yours as well, isn't it? It's one of our favourite LPs.
Yeah, I suppose you're missing a few records over here, aren't you?
Yeah, yeah.
We quite often release 12-inch records in England, just as 12-inch EPs.
They're called singles. I think you used to have them here once.
Yeah, it's all LPs over here now, isn't it? Very rare that you get 12-inches. Well, we worked on him, with him, sorry, not on him. We worked with him in November on four tracks for an EP which we released in January in Britain. And those four tracks have been put on the record, the CD version of the record, which you can get now. It's been released last week.
So you guys are just continually churning out like singles a lot, lots of 12 inches in between albums?
We usually do about two a year, which is why the LP takes so long to make, because we don't like the idea of putting all the tracks on a single on the LP. So
it's really unfortunate though for places like the Americas in general, and even Europe as well, because they don't have the same attitude to 12-inch singles that they have in Britain. And it seems to be a main thing that we do all the time. We've got 12-inch singles. It must have been about... The next one would be 10, wouldn't it?
It's 10 now, yeah.
10 12-inch singles, which is like 40 tracks, which most of which don't appear on LPs.
How do you feel about now hitting North America and trying to conquer it and playing the smaller clubs again? A lot of work?
Right. It's like it's exciting. You've got the atmosphere at a gig when you've got just a few people like that. You actually see them face to face, like I can see you now. It's much better than when you're playing a big stage and like they're about 20 yards away. And also, there's many people who come to like tonight, for instance, who well, not really have heard of the band very much. They may have had a quick inkling of one or two songs and they know roughly what it's about. And then to actually play to these people and then hopefully win some of them over as well. And you see the expressions changing as you watch you playing to them. That's really good. That's something we don't really do in England anymore. We play to a convinced audience already.
Yeah.